Good morning everyone, welcome to Ojuswata S Academy. So we are trying to cover current affairs in the form of MCQs for helping you in the upcoming exam of UPSC Prelims 2020. So today we will discuss the MCQs of 1st June and you can also join us on our Telegram channel where we upload all these PPTs and you can do multiple revision of them. So let's see what are the 10 topics which we are going to cover in today's MCQs. So here is the list is given. And please do take a pause when you see question on the screen, answer it first, then see the explanation part and try to get at least 7 questions correct out of 10. So work hard, be consistent, regularly watch our videos and let's start our today's lecture. So question number 1 is with reference to heat waves. Statement first, it is a period of abnormally high temperatures that occurs during the summer season. Second, more intense heat waves are becoming frequent globally due to climate change. So here the correct option is C, that means both the given statements are correct. So if we talk about heat waves, it is a period of abnormally high temperatures more than the normal maximum temperature that occurs during the summer season, mostly in the northwest part of India. And heat waves typically occur between March and June and in some rare cases even extend till July. And as per Indian Meteorological Department, heat wave need not be considered till the maximum temperature of a station reaches at least 40 degrees Celsius for plains and at least 30 degrees Celsius for hilly regions. And for more information, you can refer this image. Now question number 2 is with reference to Guru Arjun Dev. Second, so statement first, he was the third Sikh Guru and the first Sikh martyr. Second, he laid the foundation of Golden Temple in Amritsar in Punjab. So the correct option here is B, that is second only. And statement first is incorrect because Guru Arjun Dev was the fifth Sikh Guru, but he was first Sikh martyr. So you have to remember that he was 5th Sikh Guru, not 1st, not 2nd, not 3rd. And he also compiled all the past Gurus written into one book and now it is called as Holy Book named Guru Granth Sahib. And he included the compositions of both Hindu and Muslim saints which he considered consistent with the teachings of Sikhism and Gurus. And he was ordered to torture to death by Jahangir. So you have to remember that Guru Arjun Dev and Jahangir were contemporary to each other. Now question number 3 is with reference to Purandar Dasa. Statement first, he was a Vaishnava poet and Haridas, a devotional singer. Second, he formulated basic lessons of Carnatic music and is called the father of Carnatic music. So the correct option here is C, that means both the given statements are correct. So Purandasa was born as Srinivas Nayaka, a rich merchant, but gave away all his material riches to become a Haridas, which is deemed as devotional singer. And he also made the difficult Sanskrit tenets of Srimad Bhagavatism available to everyone in simple and melodious songs under the pen name Purandara Vithal. Also, he is known as father of Carnatic music. And the context is that the Karnataka state government has formed an expert committee to solve the mystery over the birthplace of Purandara Dasa, which is claimed by Maharashtra and Karnataka both. Now question number 4 is, State of the World's Forest Report 2020 is released recently by a joint effort of United Nations Environment Programme and which of the following organization? So here the correct option is B, that means it is joint effort of UNEP and Food and Agriculture Organization, which is FAO. And according to the report, climate change along with poor forest management practices, that is alteration of forest structure and diversity, has changed the biology and behavior of native and introduced pests and pathogens. एंड हायर टेम्परेचर्स, सीवियर एंड एक्सट्रीम वेदर इवेंट्स एंड ड्रॉट हैज रिजल्टेड इन रिड्यूस्ड वीगर ऑफ ट्रीज, मेकिंग देम मोर वल्नरेबल टू वाइल्ड फायर एंड पेस्ट अटैक्स. नाउ हेयर क्वेश्चन फॉर यू इज, यू हैव टू टेल वेयर इज यूनाइटेड नेशन एनवायरमेंट प्रोग्राम इज हेडक्वार्टर. सो नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द क्वेश्चन नंबर 5. सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 इज, फुसेरियम विल TR-4, अ नेवल स्ट्रेंथ इज हिटिंग बनाना प्लांटेशन ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. इट इज, सो यू हैव टू चूज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन. सो इट इज अ फंगल स्ट्रेन, सो ऑप्शन विल बी सी. सो यूपीएससी कैन गिव यू सिंपली द टर्म फुसारियम विल TR-4. सो यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दैट इट इज द नेवल फंगस स्ट्रेन दैट इज डिवास्टेटिंग बनाना प्लांटेशन अराउंड द वर्ल्ड एंड बींग कंपेयर्ड एज कोविड ऑफ प्लांट वर्ल्ड. सो बिकम्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. एंड TR दैट मीन्स ट्रॉपिकल रेस, 4 वॉज आइडेंटिफाइड फर्स्ट इन ताइवान एंड हैज स्प्रेडेड फ्रॉम एशिया टू द मिडल ईस्ट, अफ्रीका एंड लैटिन अमेरिका. एंड इट क्रिपल्स द प्लांटेशन बाय फर्स्ट अटैकिंग द लीव्स विच टर्न्स येलो एंड देर इज नो इफेक्टिव रेमेडी येट. एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू FAO, बनाना इज द वर्ल्ड्स मोस्ट ग्लोबली एक्सपोर्टेड फ्रूट एंड इक्वेटर इज द लार्जेस्ट एक्सपोर्टर. एंड वैन इट कम्स टू इंडिया, इंडिया इज वर्ल्ड्स लार्जेस्ट प्रोड्यूसर ऑफ बनाना. But you have to remember, India is not largest exporter, it is equator. And because bananas are consumed domestically, so India is not a largest exporter, but it is largest producer. Now question number 6 is, recently Bhil Pradesh demand was in news. Statement first, Bhils are a group of tribal indigenous people restricted in few parts of India. Second, possibly they were the largest tribal groups in India. Third, the demand for a separate state comes from the tribal belts of Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh and Gujarat. Fourth, demand for a separate Bhil Pradesh is also trending over Twitter. So here the correct option is A, because statement first is incorrect, and it is incorrect because Bhils, also spelled as Bhils, are a group of tribal indigenous people who are scattered all over India from Gujarat in the west to Tripura in the far east. So they are not restricted to some parts, they are scattered all over India. That's why it was incorrect. So here is the map is given. This is the demand from Bhil sides, and also the demand has polarized the platform into people in support and against the trend, and they mostly live in the states of Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan and Chhattisgarh. And to safeguard the rights of tribal on their own land, and the people of the community are demanding reacquisition of land from where they were made to migrate. So these are the four states from which Bhils want to carve out their own Bhil Pradesh. Now question number 7 is, recently cloud diplomacy was in news. Statement first, phone calls, exchange of correspondence and video conferencing are its form. Second, China has coined the term cloud diplomacy. Third, following cloud diplomacy, Chinese president has attended virtual summits including G20 countries and World Health Assembly. So as we have to find out incorrect statement, and all the given statements are correct, so option will be D, that is none of the above. And this is the first time in history of Rashtrapati Bhavan that Rashtrapati Bhavan credentials were presented through the digital media. And PM Modi also participated in online summits from the SAARC summit to the G20 summit and addressed Indian ambassadors all over the world through video conferencing. So India has adapted to virtual diplomacy in less than 2 months, and China has also moved ahead of this and has coined a term cloud diplomacy. Because according to Chinese foreign minister, life may have paused due to COVID-19, but diplomacy hasn't paused. Now question number 8 is, in the context of Indian economy, consider the following statements regarding depression and recession. Statement first, a recession is characterized as a period of negative economic growth for 2 consecutive quarters. Second, a depression is longer and more destructive than a recession. So here both again statements are correct, so option will be C. So if we talk about recession, unemployment will rise, output fall and government borrowings increase. एंड डिप्रेशन इज अ रिसेशन बट मच मोर सीवियर एंड लॉन्ग लास्टिंग. हाउएवर टिल नाउ देर इज नो एग्रीड डेफिनेशन ऑफ अ डिप्रेशन एंड वन पॉपुलर डेफिनेशन फॉर डिफरेंस बिटवीन रिसेशन एंड डिप्रेशन इज दैट अ रिसेशन इज वेन योर नेबर लॉसेज हिज जॉब, अ डिप्रेशन इज वेन यू लॉसेज योर्स. सो इट्स नॉट अ डेफिनेशन, इट्स अ काइंड ऑफ पॉपुलर स्टेटमेंट. नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 9 इज Tianwen 1 Mars mission of which of the following country? So the correct option is B, that means China. So in July, China is expected to launch its first Mars mission, and the success of this mission will make China the third country to achieve a Mars landing after the USSR and USA. And it is named after the ancient Chinese poem Questions to Heaven, that is the Tianwen 1. Which is an all-in-one orbiter, lander and rover which searches the Martian surface for water, ice, investigates soil characteristics and study the atmosphere and among completing other objectives. So it is yet to be launched. Now question number 10 is Malaysia shares land border with which of the following country or countries? So the correct option is C, that means Thailand. So here is the map is given and you can see Malaysia shares land boundaries with Thailand, Indonesia and Brunei, and the peninsula and island of Borneo are separated by South China Sea, and Malaysia has maritime border with Singapore, Vietnam and Philippines. So that's all in our today's MCQs. Hope you guys are liking the lecture. Also subscribe our channel and press the bell icon to get the latest update. And if you want to contact us, these are the details. And here is the link of Telegram is given, and also it is given in the description box below. You can join for the PPTs. And if you want information regarding UPPSC examination and its test series, you can also contact us. So stay safe, stay healthy, have a nice day and thank you.